the head of science down here at Arc Alexandra Lower School. Scientists explore the world from the insides of tiny atoms to the vast corners of our universe. And here at Arc Alexandra, we encourage students to investigate and ask these big questions. Science educates the students to treat their bodies and our environment with respect, understanding, and awe. We teach our students to become scientists for life and develop our students to gain the confidence and power to ask questions. We help them to harbour curiosity of how and why things work and build upon their existing knowledge through engaging lessons which will inspire the students. We link lessons to real-life context, highlighting the relevance of science to everyday situations through concrete and practical application. What I love about teaching here at Arc Alexandra are the students, their enthusiasm and love for learning and learning science. The use of practical brings the subject to life and students get involved and have a go at all types of practicals in a safe and secure environment. We look at practicals that look at the importance of surface area and rates of reaction. In years 7 and 8, students will learn topics ranging from basic cell biology and healthy eating to exploring space. They have regular opportunities for both formative and summative assessment. Teachers will circulate the room and live mark regularly, which picks up on misconceptions that our students may have. In each unit of work, students will receive an extended writing task and a mastery quiz. Mastery quizzes are used to help identify misconceptions and address these straight away with a reteach in the classroom. We provide our students with models of excellence, and these will be used for the extended writing task to help the students understand what a truly excellent answer is. Students study science to gain knowledge and skills to prepare for their future, to make the right choices about their health, the environment, and play a vital role in our community. Students will learn to have faith in themselves, develop their creativity, determination, and resilience, skills which are vital for the future of technological and scientific advances.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Rutherford and I'm the head of maths here at the Helenswood campus. I'm absolutely passionate about maths and how we learn it and how everybody learns it differently. So maths is important for success in life. It's all around us. We find maths evident throughout our whole world, including in nature and in problem-solving skills we use every day and all of the subjects we learn here at school. At Arc Alexandra, we love maths. We believe that every student should have the same opportunity, whatever their attainment level. So if you find maths tricky, that doesn't mean to say that you shouldn't have lots of challenge in your learning and learn the same content as everyone else. We want all students to have to think really hard. So our aim is to build resilient problem solvers, not just so that you can solve mathematical problems, but so that you have the skills to tackle problems in your real life. And we want our students and work really hard to get our students to enjoy maths just as much as we do. So here at the lower school, we follow the mastery approach, and they have that's got three key principles. So we want students to have a real deep understanding, so that's about understanding rather than just following rules and procedures. We want lots of problem-solving opportunities so that you think mathematically, and use of mathematical language, so we expect students to talk in full sentences and to use full mathematical language. So in maths, we want students to develop a mathematical rigour and resilience and confidence. So in our lessons, we always have opportunities for students to talk and discuss about the maths that they're doing, to relate it to real life situations. And we use lots of concrete manipulatives, so that's things like cubes, algebra tiles, to help our understanding. And we use things called bar models, and lots of you at primary school will have done that. We always have time for silent practice in lessons, so that there's time to practice and hone our skills. So we also have three assessments a year and an ongoing formative assessment. So that means that we do lots of quizzes and things just to make sure we understand where you're up to in your learning. We believe that home study is a really important part of the student's learning journey. So in year seven and eight, students will do an hour's homework a week. That we use Hegarty Maths, which is an online resource that we provide for you. So every week you watch a video followed by a quiz. So maths at the lower school affords our students an excellent grounding for their mathematical career and prepares them well for their continuing study at Key Stage 4 and 5. I very much look forward to seeing you all in September.
Good evening, Year 6. Welcome to English at Arc Alexandra Academy. Throughout your time at Arc Alexandra, in English, you will develop the knowledge and skills necessary to read for meaning and thus develop a love of words that will remain with you for the rest of your life. You will study a range of challenging texts from our rich literary heritage, along with modern texts from a range of diverse writers. Each story you will study will challenge your understanding of the world and how we build relationships with each other. At Arc Alexandra, we have three types of English lesson: literary heritage, reading for pleasure, and mastery writing. And each type of lesson will help you develop the skills and knowledge to be successful. In our literary heritage lessons, you learn how to make links between the text and the context, the time and place in which it was written. You will study texts such as Charles Dickens' Oliver Twist, watching the poor, vulnerable orphan make his way through the dark, foggy streets of Victorian London. Or you might be studying Shakespeare's A Midsummer Night's Dream, or perhaps later on one of his tragedies. In our Reading for Pleasure lessons, you will study a wide range of modern texts. It might be a play, a novel, a poem, but either way, you will develop a rich vocabulary and a deep understanding of how a writer structures a text to impact upon the reader. In our mastery writing lessons, you will develop your technical accuracy. You will learn that when your writing is perfect, your writing is accurate, clear, and thoughtfully constructed, you can influence others. In every lesson, you will learn to actively listen and understand how to use spoken language with confidence. Our classrooms are oracy rich, and we all respond thoughtfully in full sentences using standard English. We engage in lots of healthy debate and discuss all sorts of challenging ideas. Ultimately, success in English means that you will become a highly employable, happy, and successful student who can go on to contribute to your community.
Hi, welcome to the art department at Arc Alexandra. I'm Mr. Woodhead. I may be one of your teachers next year, alongside quite a really strong support staff. We've got Miss Elliot, who's a really good art teacher who focuses on painting. We've got Mr. Mardle, who's interested in photography. And I'm myself interested in printmaking. Now, when you come here at Year 7, the great thing is that you'll get to do it in designated rooms. And then you get to actually focus on art for an hour a week in your timetable. Now, the first project that a Year 7 would do would be to actually look at abstract art, which may be something you already know, maybe something that you want to find out a bit more about before you come along. But we'll start off by looking at abstract art and developing our watercolour painting skills and learning how to create abstract compositions using geometric shapes, using colour, and using watercolour. Now, if you carry on and like the idea of taking art further on, at maybe Key Stage 4, then we have a great opportunity for you to do GCSE art, we have opportunity for you to do photography, which both subjects you can do lots of different independent stuff. So if you're interested in photographing everyday life, you're interested in photographing people, you might want to take photography. Or if you're interested in art at Year 10, we'll start off by looking at portraiture, and you might be interested in developing your oil painting skills. So we're open for you to actually develop yourselves independently and try to do as much as you like as you can that you're interested in doing to become an artist in your own right. Now, our ethos as a department is that we're here to make you become independent learners and artists that come up with imaginative, creative, and artistic outcomes.
Hello, Year 6, and welcome to Arc Alexandra. This is the catering department, and some would say the best department in the school, especially me. You will learn lots of new skills here. You will learn how to cook, how to plan for nutritious meals, We do lots of fun things. Some of the dishes that we make in year seven are pizza toast, fruit salad, potato salad, and many, many more dishes. Students will have the opportunity to study the subject for half an academic year and then move to design technology where they will learn other skills. The course that we do at GCSE is hospitality and catering, and it looks at the industry. So things that you will learn in here will move you forward to studying at GCSE. We have a lot of students that move on to work in hospitality and catering and go on to further education to study the subject too. We will look at nutrition, planning meals for different age groups, life skills, learning skills that you can apply throughout life that will help you to lead healthier lifestyles. We will look at careers and opportunities that arise in our subject. But most importantly, we hope that you'll have fun studying our subject. We can't wait to meet you.
So welcome to ARC Alexandra's Religious Studies Department. This is a core subject at our school as we are part of the church school status requirement. Within our subject, students will study all of the religions and inclusive of non-religious beliefs. We feel it's important to develop students' religious literacy, understanding of scripture, theology, and philosophical questions. So some of our students in Key Stage 3 will explore whether God exists, how the world was created, the problem of evil and suffering. Our GCSE students will study Christianity and Islam as their two main subjects, and then they will have questions around ethical approaches, such as should the UK reinstitute capital punishment. So our students develop thinking, dialogue, debate, and evaluation of their own attitudes, religious attitudes, and social change.
Hola, bienvenidos. Soy profesora Woodley. Hola. My name is Miss Woodley and I'm head of Spanish here at ARC Alexandra Academy. Welcome to the Languages Department. Here are a few quotes that I'd like to share with you that we try to live by within our Languages Department. You live a new life for every new language you speak. If you only know one language, you only live once. The limits of my language are the limits of my universe. If you talk to a man in a language he understands, that goes to his head. If you talk to him in his language, that goes to his heart. Languages and communication are so important. Some of the benefits of learning a language include boosting brain power, improving memory, sharpening the mind, enhancing decision making. Our first language is improved, so our use of English can improve by studying a foreign language. Overall, it can improve academic performance and increases our chances of networking skills and opportunities to meet other new people, can provide better career choices, and enhance our ability to multitask. And also, it keeps the mind young and active.
Okay, bonsoir, and welcome to Modern Foreign Languages, ARC Alexandra. My name is Mrs. Burfitt, and I'm head of French. I'm just going to talk to you about our intent. We're very passionate about modern foreign languages at Alexandra, as they are an important part of education, and there are many cognitive and cultural benefits, and we believe that every student should have the opportunity to study another language. Our aim is for students to become emotionally intelligent, confident global citizens with language skills, which will enable them to secure a place in today's competitive international job market and today's multicultural society. The MFL curriculum will do this by developing speaking, listening, reading and writing skills over a range of topics in French or Spanish in order to achieve the highest academic outcomes. We will also inspire students' love of the language and broaden their horizons by placing an emphasis on cultural knowledge and authentic resources, including studying festivals, literature, history and songs, as learning another language is not only learning different words for the same things, but learning another way to think about things.
Hello, and welcome to ARC Alexandra Academy. We're here to tell you about our history department, and we are reporting to you from the heart of Helenswood campus in room 5 to tell you all about our history department and curriculum.
This is Mrs. Murphy, who is here to introduce to prospective parents and students what we view history as, and what we learn in our school.
History, the study of history, is really everything. History is the study of how our past has led to our present. So we can understand everything that we've done in our present lives by understanding the context of it and how we've got here. History is the study of our identity, whether that's our identity in a local sense or in a national sense or in a global sense. History is actually the study of documents, of what the past has left behind, and it's actually the study of how we can look at those documents critically, and then by looking at those documents critically, we can look at any present document that we have critically, which is absolutely fundamentally important in our modern day perspective. So history gives us so many skills and is so much. It is the study of fantastic individuals. It is the study of amazing watershed moments that have actually had an impact all through our lives. And it's actually not just the study of this country, it's the study of our global world and really how we've got to today where we're so interconnected.
So we will hope to incite your curiosity for the past and offer a wide range of topics that will bring the past right up to the present, including the suffragette movement, feminist history, medieval women, issues of power, and issues that have led to the current Black Lives Movement.
Following on from that, if we think about our history curriculum as a whole at Key Stage 3, we really start with sort of what is history, history skills, and then we look at Roman and Anglo-Saxon Britain, so we go right back to early medieval times. We have a look at the Battle of Hastings in a lot more depth than you've done it already. And then we continue with medieval history, then we go up through history where we have a look at the Tudors and we have a look at the Civil War in England. We also have a look at the transatlantic slave trade, we have a look at empire, and we sort of think, well, what can we learn from all of those things? Because we have a very, very, very varied past in Britain, and so we have a look at what we can learn from all of that. Then what we do is we go up and we learn about the wars. We learn about World War I, we learn about World War II, the Industrial Revolution just before that. And then we have a further look at the 20th century in year 9, where we're looking at Nazi Germany. We have a look a little bit at the Cold War, and then we have a look at the civil rights movement in America and in Britain. And all of these things give us the context for where our world is today. Now you might be thinking, the study of the past, where will it take me in my future? Well, it's very, very interesting at that, because there are many jobs out there that actually require or where a history degree is very beneficial. If you want to do anything in the film industry, for example, any period dramas, you need to have a knowledge of history. Actually, if you're thinking about going into technology, well, actually the use of technology is actually really, really, really giving us a lot more answers about the past, because we're actually able to analyze things in a far more, using technology today to do that. You can become a journalist, you can become a politician, you can become a travel agent, you can become just about anything with a history degree. So it's a really rich thing to have with in your life to actually present.
And there are a lot of very famous people who have studied history. Prince Charles, Shakira, Sacha Baron Cohen, Louis Thoreau. Those are just a few names that we need to mention. For those who are unsure what they want to do in the future, history is also a very valuable subject. It's praised and highly regarded as a respected discipline. The skills we teach is such critical analysis, research, writing at a very high level. These are the skills that prove invaluable to employers in countless fields of work.
Okay, so fundamentally, history is a written subject, and so we do expect our students to be able to meet a certain level of quality and maintain that. We build the students up from year 7 onwards to reach certain standards of quality, and we help them actually keep working as they go. We do make sure every single lesson has some form of interactive or group element, because fundamentally, history is a constantly changing and evolving subject. We do need to learn and teach the children how to critically analyse everything they see. So whether that's an interpretation, whether that's a source, or whether that's some form of evidence. And we do then regularly circle back and actually look at the themes and the overriding kind of messages between the different periods of history, so they can actually link up and understand how history is moving on.
So that gives you a little introduction and a little flavour of what we do here at ARC Alexandra with history. It is engaging, it is interesting, it is fascinating. We are a team of dedicated, absolute history enthusiasts dedicated to our subject. Absolutely love it. And we would love to have you here and love to teach you next year in our history department.
Hello, Year 6. Welcome to Design and Technology. My name is Miss Hawes. Our aim in design and technology is for you to develop a lifelong love of our subject and be as passionate about it as we are. Design and technology is a really fun subject as you get to design and make your own unique products that are different to anyone else's. It is a really important subject as everything around you has been designed and made. The chair you're sitting on, the building you're in, the transport you last used, the clothes you're wearing, these are just some of the things around you that have been designed and made. So we will give you the skills to be the next architect, fashion designer, builder, or whatever career you want to follow, design and technology will help you do it. By the end of year 11, you will be independently making really creative and innovative products using a wide range of tools and machinery, including the latest technologies such as CAD/CAM, as we have a laser cutter and a 3D printer, which we use to precisely make your products and model your ideas in 3D. In year 7, one of your projects is a lamp inspired by designs from a culture of your choice. You will develop a range of skills in this project, including being able to draw accurately in 3D and draw parts on a computer so they can be laser cut. You will also use lots of different traditional tools and machinery in a workshop and will do some electronics to make your lamp light up. As well as working in wood, we also work with plastics, metals, paper and card, textiles and smart materials. So you will get to make lots of exciting products in a range of materials which you can take home and be proud of. In year 8, you will get to work in teams and will compete against each other to program a robot so it can complete different challenges. You'll also work with plastics in year 8. We want you to leave Arc Alexandra as independent, creative, practically minded, solution focused and skilled in the latest technologies. You will develop faith in yourself and resilience, which will make you unafraid to face challenges and persevere in order to solve problems. This will help you actively participate in a rapidly changing technological world, which considers the needs of people and the environment. My department will encourage and support you to achieve excellence in everything that you do. We're really looking forward to teaching you next year and getting you to enjoy design and technology as much as we do.
Geography is about asking questions. Ask yourself, where do you live? How long has your family lived there? How does living where you are affect the way that you live? For example, do you need special clothes in the winter? Do you get your food grown locally? All these questions have to do with geography. Geography is the study of our home, the earth, and how our lives are affected by it. Almost every detail of our lives is affected by geography. The clothes we wear, the food we eat, where we grow up. Ask yourselves these 6 questions next time you're out shopping. If you're buying food, where is it grown? Why is it grown there and not in the UK or not down the road? Why does the place look the way which it does? What other places are like it? How do people use those resources to grow food? And what challenges do they face? Whilst you're thinking about those 6 questions, little do you know, you're actually studying geography. They're at the basis, at the heart of what geography is. These elements are the world in spatial terms, places and regions, physical systems, human systems, the environment and society. These are our different uses of geography.
At Arc Alexandra, students can study geography for 7 years, taking them from the very start of year 7 all the way until the end of year 13. In year 7 and 8, students study some key themes about different areas of geography. So it could be human or physical geography, and we study those in isolation. These things include some things that you as parents may have studied at school as well. Things like tectonics, we look at rivers and coasts. As we live on the coastline, it's really important that we learn about the processes here. We look at human geography such as population and urbanisation and our use of resources to see if we can try and use them as sustainably as possible. In year 9, students then take the knowledge they have of those themes and apply them to a range of geographical regions around the world. For example, currently in year 9 we're studying sub-Saharan Africa, We're understanding the human and physical processes that are taking place there and which have happened in the past to try to ensure that we have a full and clear understanding of the challenges but also the opportunities that face sub-Saharan Africa. In year 10 and 11, students then study their GCSE. We carry on with the AQA syllabus, which includes, again, a vast range of physical and human geography, but has the add of fieldwork, which is something that your son or daughter, when they reach their GCSE, will have the opportunity in doing. This means getting outside, which is where the geography really is, collecting some data, and then analysing it when they get back to class. Should your student, your pupil, or your son, daughter, wish to study A-level geography, it then takes us forward looking at contemporary issues around our world. Students take great care in studying physical and human processes in depth and really coming away with a real accurate and full pitch understanding of our world. And often students will then go on to university, some of which go on to study geography at university also.
So why do we learn geography at ARC Alexandra? We've condensed our geography intent into just kind of three simple bullet points just here. I'll talk you through them and then I'll show you them. So we learn geography so we can develop an interest in human and physical environments and the interactions between them. This means how do our actions change the planet that we live in? For example, how does building a city change an environment? How does burning fossil fuels change the atmosphere? We also need to understand, well, how can we make a positive impact? Both on a local scale, things nearby, and at a global scale. In geography, we look at the local and global issues, seeing how things were in the past and how they might be in the future. It's about seeing that big picture. And if we don't like the future that we see, it's about what we can do to change it. Geography is also about problem solving. We look at issues from many different viewpoints and perspectives, which allows us to come up with unique solutions. This combination of physical and social sciences makes geographers highly employable, allowing them to work in an ever-changing and more demanding workplace. By now, you've heard us talk about what topics you might study and how geography might be relevant to your lives. Now, we hope that you will study geography just because of its importance in terms of global events. If we think, particularly at the moment with the kind of COVID-19 pandemic and looking at mapping, how it's spreaded. Climate change, one of the most pressing issues of particularly your generation's lifetime. Rising sea levels, if you think of growing populations and the lack of food and water. These are all issues which geography will cover. But beyond just studying so you can learn to live sustainably, so you can learn to deal with all of these issues, geography is also important for a range of different careers. Now, there's quite general skills which you'll learn in geography and that geographers are quite valued for, but there's also quite specific roles. After going on to study geography at university, you might look into jobs in terms of environmental consultancy, cartography in terms of planning maps, particularly at the moment, people that I studied with work in a software called GIS, which is Geographical Information Systems, basically layering different maps to work out where to build. For example, Tesco, if they're building a new store, might think, right, I need to know where the best place to do that is. That's what a kind of GIS consultant might do. Of course, teachers, the finest job that you can do. The list is almost endless with the skills which you will get. Geography inspires people to look at the world beyond their window and how it actually works. We are so excited to see you come in September and start that process of studying geography with us. We really can't wait to see you.
Hello and welcome to Year 11 Business Studies and the Business Studies, Economics and Vocational Department. So we're a department made up of subjects which students will study in year 10 all the way through to year 13. Those subjects are health and social care, business, economics and business studies. But it's probably better coming from the students than from me. Louis is a year 11 digital technology student. Louis, can you tell me a little bit about digital technology?
Well, what we're learning in digital technology is a handful of things. to start with is Excel pieces that we can use and interpret our own data, analyze our own data, make our own assumptions about what has been made with the data, help organize it better, also to better ourselves with formulas and create better ideas on how we can make the formula better, how we can make a description of how what we've made has been done, also how we can structure better, and many other different things that we cover.
And Louis, do you think studying digital technology will help you when you leave school? Is it something you want to study?
I definitely think I would like to, and it'll definitely help me in the future, yes.
Lovely, thanks Louis. Luanne is a Year 11 Health and Social Care student. Luanne, can you tell me a little bit about Health and Social Care?
In Health and Social Care I work with, we learn about people with from ages 0 to 65 plus, and we learn about their physical, intellectual and emotional and social development.
Anyway, did you take part in work experience last year?
I went on 1 week of work experience where I worked with children from the ages 0 to 2 in helping them in nursery.
Lovely. And do you think this is something you want to do after school, after you finish school?
I think it's prepared me to help make a decision about that I want to work with children in the primary school.
In business, we are learning about setting up our own micro enterprises and pitching the ideas to our audiences. I really enjoy business, and in the future, I would like to own my own business as well.
Welcome to the PE department at Arc Alexandra Academy. At our Helenswood campus, we have a large multi-use sports hall with 4 badminton courts, a basketball court, netball court, and a gymnastics tumble track. We also have a beautiful dance studio with mirrors, bar and sprung floor, as well as outside facilities, including a full pitch and netball courts. On our William Parker site, we have another full-size multi-use sports hall, a sprung gymnastics floor and tumble track, as well as 2 smaller sports halls, a fully equipped dance studio and theatre space, and of course, our newly refurbished athletics arena. In addition to this, we have large rugby and football pitches. Sport and PE have long been an important part of life at the Academy. Over many years, we have proudly produced athletes and teams who have represented us at a range of events, from local leagues to national finals. Last year, our Year 11 boys football team reached the semi-finals of the National Cup, an event contested by over 700 schools, and our gymnastics team retained their title as Sussex Schools Champions for the 15th consecutive year. Students have access to a range of sports and activities through lessons, extracurricular clubs and enrichment opportunities. Our reputation for sporting excellence is widely revered, and we are looking forward to discovering the next wave of talented athletes. Within curriculum lessons, students will learn and develop skills and concepts in a range of sports, including football, netball, gymnastics, fitness, basketball, badminton, table tennis, dance, athletics, striking and fielding games, trampolining, cross-country and outdoor and adventurous activities. It is our mission for students to enjoy PE and sport, regardless of experience or ability. We want students to understand the importance of leading active, healthy lifestyles and develop the resilience and perseverance to strive for their personal best. We understand that for some students, PE would not be their first choice, but we hope that they will enjoy their time with us and go on to be active when they leave us. We hope that this has given you an insight into the physical education at Arc Alexandra Academy, and look forward to welcoming you into our family in 2021.
Welcome to Performing Arts. Performing Arts opens up a world of possibilities for our students. Here you will build your skills in dance, drama, and music, and you will develop skills that will support you right across the curriculum, things like confidence, creativity and teamwork. We produce excellent results in performing arts, and the quality of work we do is absolutely outstanding. We have a rich enrichment program, so many things you can take part in. You can be part of shows, musicals, concerts and workshops. We do trips and take people out to see professional theatre. You will have a great time. Performing arts is engaging, thrilling and challenging, and you will love it. Do something remarkable. Join us at Arc Alexandra.